Hey everybody, my name is Kim Siever. Welcome back to my channel. I get that it's problematic for Justin Trudeau to dress up in brownface, but it's also problematic when we focus on it. When we call out racism of other people, we perpetuate the idea that racism is restricted to a small collection of acts. We otherize racism. These things that other people do is racism, and since we don't do them, we are not racist. And it doesn't matter whether it's Donald Trump calling Mexican immigrants animals and rapists, or it's Justin Trudeau wearing brownface. The point is the same. When we highlight their specific acts, especially when they're acts that we wouldn't participate in, we make racism foreign to us, making us immune to it. Except we're not immune to it. Each of us is racist. You see, racism isn't innate. It's something we have to learn. We learn it from our friends, from our parents, from the media, from classmates, from neighbors, from Sunday school teachers, from siblings, and from a whole host of everyday interactions with others. Racism can be taught in several ways. It can be how a parent responds to a person of color walking by on the street, or how a cashier responds to a non-white customer, or how a cop changes how they talk to someone based on their skin color. And we all pick it up over time, and it becomes part of our understanding about racialized people. It's how groups of people become racialized. And we can't hide our own racism behind the overt racism of public figures. Focusing on their racism doesn't absolve us of ours. See this photo by Sean Kilpatrick of the Canadian Press? Where are the people of color among the reporters questioning Trudeau on his racism? Maybe while the media is nailing Trudeau to the wall for his racism, they can investigate why their reporting corps is so white. Speaking of hypocrisy, where are all the people calling on Trudeau to apologize and step down on the racism inherent in the justice system? Where are they on the racism inherent in the everyday lives of people of color as they try to shop, try to rent homes, try to get jobs? Where are they on the racism inherent in the systemic removal of children from Indigenous communities? You want to call out political leaders on their racism? Fine. But you better be calling out the racism around you while you're at it, including your own. Thanks for watching.
You can follow me online at siever.ca/Kim. I'm also on Facebook, Twitter, and Tumblr. If you appreciate the videos I share here on YouTube, the posts I write on my blog, and the content I share on my other social media accounts, please consider making a monthly donation, either through PayPal or Patreon. Creating and curating this content takes a lot of time, but I'm also running a business, which makes my time limited. Your donation would mean I wouldn't have to drum up business to pay my bills, which would allow me to devote more time to researching issues like this one, and I could post videos like this more often. Thank you for your consideration and your support.
If you agree with the points I raised in my video, please give me a thumbs up and let me know in the comments below why. Please share my video and subscribe to my channel. And I look forward to talking to you again soon.